My name is Naveed, and today I am telling you how to solve a Rubik's Cube by beginner's method 3x3. It has three main parts: center, edge, and corners. To understand how these algorithms work, you have to learn the Rubik's Cube lingo like R, L, U, F, D, and V. An apostrophe means that the layer should move counterclockwise by 90 degrees. No apostrophe means it goes 90 degrees clockwise. When there's a number next to the letter, it stands for the number of turns you should make. So here's the main algorithm for your right hand. It will be R, U, R prime, and U prime. Or you can say that it is R apostrophe or U apostrophe. It's the exact opposite for your left hand, like L apostrophe, U apostrophe, L, U. Let's see how they work to do. Before you continue, it's a good idea to pause this video and practice until you can do all the moves pretty much automatically. It will help you later. We have 7 stages to solve the Rubik's Cube. Number 1, the white cross. Number 2, the middle layer, means this one and this one. These two layers are the middle layers. Number 4, the yellow cross. Number 5, the top layer. Number 6, the top corners. And number 7, the final goal, means the whole Rubik's Cube. We will start to make a white cross. First, our task is to put together a white cross and align us with the right color center on each side. So first, I have to mix it up. Now you can see that I have scrambled it. You can see. Yes. Now let's get started. So first we have to put the together this sequence that like this. It's really easy and doesn't require any special algorithm. Try it yourself first. So let's try. You have to put this color to this color. I will do like this. This color is there. This is there. So I move this middle layer and then shift this. You can see this color is there and it shifts to this. Now you can see that there is a color. So I will simply move it by right hand, and then you can see that this color is there and we have to put this on this color. So I will simply move first layer to there and then move this one. Now you can see the white cross has been made, but you have to make this white cross on this side because there is a center of white. So we have to match this color to their centers. This color is there, green. I will simply move this, and then I have to move this 180 degree. It's like this. You can see that it matches this color. Now I have to put the other colors this 90 degree move, then this one. You can see that so our white cross has been made. And you also see that these colors are matched with their centers, like red is matched with their center, blue is matched with their center, and the all colors are matched with their centers, and the white cross is also made. Number 2. Solve the four corners pieces on the bottom. At this stage, you will have to put the lower corners on the cube in the right places, and the white side of the cube will be solved. Now, you only have to do two algorithms, which is right hand one means this one, and you have to do the left hand one, this one. So, let's get started. Rotate only the top layer and of the cube and find a corner that's the same color as the center of the other sides. You can see that white is there, orange is there, and green is also there. So I can do the right hand algorithm. And you also have to do this algorithm with other sides. Now you can see the lower layer has been solved, and the white side is also solved. Solve the four edge pieces in the middle layer. At this stage, you need to solve the rest of the middle layer so that the blocks are the same color as the center. In the first case, the layer you will be working with is to must match it with the right color. At this stage, you have to move the first layer, means this one, to right side like this, and you have to do the left hand algorithm one time like this, and you have to move the cube to the blue color like this, and you have to do the right hand algorithm one time. So you can see the red and blue color has been matched with their centers. And we have to do all the centers. We have to match the other edge pieces with their centers. So let's do that. Now you can see all the middle layer has been solved, and the white cross is also solved. Solve the yellow edges on the top layer first. You put together a yellow cross on the yellow side of the cube. If you don't see the yellow line, but only a random set of yellow edges, start see the yellow line, starting doing the same algorithm, and this is how you get across. First you have to do this. You can see that this is a 9 o'clock, so you have to move this layer to there, and you have to do the right hand algorithm until the yellow color is not there. Now you can see that the yellow color is there, and now you have to shift this color to this. Now you can see it. The yellow cross has been made. Now you can see this cube is matched with their centers. This cube is also matched with their centers. And these cubes are not matching with their centers. So we have to do this one. Right hand one. Three times. And shift this to there. Move. And do the left hand algorithm three times. Now you can see all the cubes are matching with their centers. Now we have to fill these colors with yellow. So we have to flip the cube like this. And you have to do the right hand algorithm until the yellow color goes to there. So let's get started. Now you can see that the yellow colors goes there, then the other colors also have to fill. You can see it goes. Now you can see the yellow side has been solved, and the blue side has been solved, and the white side is also has been solved. These colors is there only. So this is the last step, and you have to put these color with their centers. Means you have to put this red to there, you have to put this orange to there, yes, and you have to put this green to there. So we have to do this one. You can see that blue side has been solved. So we have to do the right hand algorithm one time, and the left hand algorithm one time. Then you have to do the right hand algorithm 5 times. Now you have to do the left hand algorithm 5 times. You can see it hasn't solved. So we have to do this again. We have to do the right hand algorithm 1 time, then 1 time left hand algorithm, then you have to do the 5 times right hand algorithm, then you have to do the left hand algorithm 5 times. Now you can see the whole cube has been solved. Thank you.